Hello everyone, and welcome to my second tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use the Firestorm Viewer to access Second Life. Firestorm is a third-party viewer. It's made by fans of Second Life for fans of Second Life, and it's free. In my first video, I was using the standard Second Life viewer, as it's stable, offered on account creation, and simple to use. However, I spent most of my Second Life using Firestorm, and that is the viewer that I'm most experienced with. I think it's a very good viewer with an excellent support system and a lot of features. As it's where my expertise lies, I shall be doing all of my tutorials with Firestorm. If you'd like to follow along, then I will show you how to get a copy of the viewer and also how to customise your GUI. If you're not familiar with the term GUI, then let me assure you that it's not as root as it sounds. It just means graphical user interface. Firestorm has a lot of features, and customising what works for you before you do anything else, and knowing how to change it as you go along, of course, will really ease the Second Life learning curve. Okay, so on my screen now you can see the Firestorm Viewer page. Please note that the address is firestormviewer.org. Do not use any other site to download the Firestorm Viewer. This is the only official site, and any others should be avoided at all costs. Find the download link at the top of the page here, and then choose your operating system. You may want to check the specs required to run the viewer, as it can be a little intensive, but all viewers of Second Life are. I will show you ways to decrease the load on your computer, so if you can run it, I can show you how to adapt it to suit you, at least in theory. Now here's the screen that you'll see when you've loaded your Firestorm Viewer. Fill in the name here that you gave yourself when you created your account, and your password. You can check the Remember Password box if you wish, and the username too, which is useful should you end up having more than one avatar. If you've forgotten your password, you can retrieve it here. Hopefully, you took my advice and you saved your details. Got them typed in? Then let's log in. As you log in, the viewer will show you a picture of your avatar at one of the locations that you were last at. It may not be where you last were. However, you will arrive at your last location. In my case, it was at Radio Spiral. I won't make you wait to watch everything load. We'll just go straight along and look at the viewer itself. Remember how we learned to move our viewpoint with Alt Control or Command and left mouse? I'm going to come around so you can see my avatar while I talk about the GUI, graphical user interface. I'll go through the things you need to know most. There is so much I couldn't possibly cover it all in one tutorial. Okay, at the top of the screen here you'll see the release number of the viewer. Like all viewers, Firestorm is updated frequently to keep up with the latest additions to Second Life, and if you ever need to compare your viewer number with the latest release to check you've got the latest one, this is where you'll find it. Let me show you another control that's very important, certainly to us at Radio Spiral. Most places you visit will allow you to listen to music that the landowners have chosen. And if you go to a music event, you'll certainly want to listen to that. If I press this button with the music notes, I can enable Parcel Stream. That is, I can listen to the music that's playing where I am. When I click it, I'm shown the domain where the music is coming from. As it's showing as coming from Radio Spiral, I will of course allow it. This feature means that you can be sure you know where the music is coming from before you accept. So now I can hear the music, and you'll see that I'm also told the track and who it's by. In my next video on preferences, I'll show you how to set it so you can get these tags too, as you may not have them enabled by default. I would also point out that the music control is a toggle, so if I press it again, then it turns the music off. If you look underneath the black bar, you'll see a second line of features. These arrows allow you to go back to the last place you were at, that's the back arrow. Use the forward arrow, which will take you to the next place you've been if you've visited a few locations. So, quick teleport. Something you will definitely want to know is how to set your home location. This button is your home button. Press it and you will be instantly teleported home. To set home, go to the top menu, choose World, then Set Home to here. Then this spot you're standing on will be where you will be teleported when you click the home button. You'll get a little dialog box showing that it's been set, so that you know you've done it correctly. Setting home is ideal if you ever have a home in Second Life, but you may choose to set it anywhere where permission is given. Many newcomer help places allow you to set home there. Radio Spiral Group listeners may set home to our parcel if they choose. I've set mine here because I'm going to be here a lot. Of course, I can always reset it, and so can you. Now I'm going to show you how to set a landmark. If you go somewhere and you want to be able to return there, then a landmark will make it very much easier for you to find the place. On the top menu, go to World and then Landmark This Place. A dialog box will come up. You can give the landmark a different name if you wish. Close that box down and then you'll see a box that will show you where the landmark is. You can close that down too. The easiest way to find it is to go to your inventory. Look for the landmarks folder and there it is, along with one I created earlier. Double clicking on a landmark in this folder will take you directly to that location. Now there's a way of keeping your favourite landmarks available to you. Here you'll see the favourites bar. To add a landmark to the bar, you left click and hold the landmark so it's highlighted. Keep holding the left mouse button and drag the chosen landmark up until the lock icon disappears from your mouse, then release. And there it is. If you click on the landmark on this bar now, it will take you straight to the point where you made the landmark. Now let's look at the icons at the bottom of the screen, which are really useful and customizable. You'll see that you have a chat bar here. I shall show you how to change its size in a moment. This is where you type to talk to people around you. If you click the nearby chat box here, it will bring up a conversation dialog box. You'll find as you get into Second Life, you'll use this a lot. There are two tabs at the bottom. The first is Contacts, which has a list of your friends, which I have none at the moment apart from Gypsy. Notice there are some icons next to her name. If you hover over them, you can see what they are for. The first means that my friend can see when I'm online. This comes up as default. You can of course uncheck it, but then your friends won't know when you're around, so there's not much point. The second button means that your friend can locate you on the map. If you want some quiet time, uncheck it. The third button is one you have to be careful with. It means that your friend can edit, delete, or take your objects. I suggest that unless you trust them implicitly, you do not click this button. As Gypsy is my alt, which means alternative avatar, I will allow her to do this. You see that when I do, a warning notice comes up. The last two buttons show what your friend has allowed you to do. You can see that I can't click them. Now this tab is for groups. I belong to one group, that's Radio Spiral. You're allowed up to 42 groups and they fill out fast. You can see I have one of 42. The buttons at the bottom of the screen here are customizable. You will probably want to change these because I know that I will. For starters, I don't really want to post anything to Facebook from here, so it's just taking up space. To remove a button from the bar, right click on the button you wish to remove. You'll get a menu pop up. choose Remove This button. You can also add buttons to the screen. Right click a button and choose Toolbar Buttons. You'll see there are a lot of choices. If I wanted to add that button back, though I don't, I can drag it down to the bar and put it anywhere. I can even add it to the sides of the screen. You can see the areas that you can move it to highlighted in blue. I'm going to add the Build button because I love creating things in Second Life. Everything you see in Second Life, right down to the blades of grass by my feet, were created by a Second Life resident. So I'll click on the button in the dialog box, hold it down and drag it onto my screen. You can also move the buttons that are already there. Just left click and drag to where you would like the button. You may find that the icons aren't enough for you to know what the buttons do. Well, that's okay, we can make it easier. Right click on any button and you'll see you can choose to show the button's text description or have both text and icons. Before we finish the video, I'd like to show you one more thing that will help you get a taste for Second Life right now. This button here is the Destinations button. If you click it, it shows you some of the most popular destinations at the moment. There are several categories: What's Hot Now, Featured Events, and Editor's Picks, amongst others. Be aware that the Adults section means adult. If we look at Editor's Picks, you'll see that there's this pretty looking Footprints in the Snow location. Let's click and go see it. When you arrive at some locations, you'll get a notice offering you note cards of info or landmarks. If you feel safe with the place, then you can accept them. Some also ask to show your profile picture. I will say no, as I have not created a profile yet. That's for another video. It looks like this was a good choice. It's very pretty here. I shall go and explore, and hope that you might too. Well, I'm back from my exploration. In case you think I've forgotten to show you how to resize the chat bar, I haven't. All you need to do is left click on the handle at the end here, hold and drag it. This is the bar that you type in to speak to anyone around. Chat distance is 20 meters. Anyone further away will not hear you. You can shout by pressing Control and Enter after you've written your message, but this will send the message to everyone within 100 meters. You can also whisper by holding Shift and pressing Enter. When you whisper, only people within 10 meters can hear you. Well, that brings us to the end of this video. Do join me for the next one, and thank you for watching.